just focusing on his tennis. And he's been at a consistently high level throughout this tournament. There haven't been peaks and valleys, really, for Noah Rubin. He's faced some challenges.
Yeah.
But then he just kind of digs down inside himself and fights through them.
Michael Moe getting here by way of defeating the two-seed Ernesto Escobedo a couple of days ago. And that was highly dramatic. And
Michael Moe getting through Escobedo.
Yep. Yep. That's what I said. The seven-seed, yep. Michael Moe defeating Double E, the two-seed. And that was a huge challenge for him, overcoming adversity in that match to get here. Michael Moe of Temple Hills, Maryland, I would call that one of the better feel-good stories as the seven-seed making it to the semifinals.
Yeah, and he's an awesome and accomplished doubles player. The Moe-Escobedo match was dramatic throughout the match. The play was good, but at the end, a challenged line call that went against Ernesto Escobedo, and Escobedo walked away from the court really frustrated and really wasn't available to shake the hand of Michael Moe and the chair umpire at the conclusion. E squared, as I call him, played outstanding tennis throughout the tournament. It was just a very difficult moment at the end of that match.
All right, so we're in the process of setting up both the boys' 16 and 18 singles final brackets. We set half of the 16 brackets earlier this morning. John McNally, the top seed in straight sets over the 4-seed Gianni Ross. And Crawford and Hance on the verge of splitting sets. In the other half here, it's Michael Moe to serve the first half of the 18 single semis. And a huge serve right out of the gate for the seven seed.
Yeah, Michael Moe, big time serve, big time athleticism. Working the corners, and you're gonna see that a little bit from Michael Moe, trying to get Noah Rubin extended. Noah Rubin, not a tall player, but extremely quick. Again, the wind blowing out of the north. It's at Noah Rubin's back.
And right to the baseline. Noah Rubin's mechanics also have seemed to go up a notch since from last year to this year. He's always been a very heavy hitter for his size, but it just seems like he's tightened up a few things.
He's not the 6'5" lanky player that a Deaton Bauman is. But he's mechanically excellent, extremely quick. Miss it. Again, that little change in trajectory that Noah Rubin threw into that point, I think generated that framed error by Michael Moe. And that's another neat little tactic, is that rather than driving flat ball after ball, Noah Rubin will change spins a little bit, and he'll change trajectory of the ball. But the wind is actually now, it can be a factor.
And a huge serve once again for Michael Moe, 40-15.
40-30,
excuse me.
And there is a split in that boys' 16 semifinal. Crawford winning the second set, splitting with Connor Hance. Michael Moe with a service ace.
Put the exclamation mark on the opening service game of the seven seed Michael Moe. He's up one love, rolling along.
Well, he's been a really, really outstanding player throughout the tournament, demonstrating his athletic ability in both singles and doubles. Noah Rubin, although he doesn't look like a classic doubles player, is also extremely good. You might find Michael Moe at the net slightly more than Noah Rubin. Noah Rubin doesn't really construct points to put himself at the net. He'll go there and execute when needed. Michael Moe, with his athletic ability, might press forward to the net a little more often than Noah Rubin.
This is the first half of the boys 18 singles semifinal. The other half will feature the 5-seed Colin Altamirano and the 4-seed Stefan Kozlov. Here is Noah Rubin at 0-1 first set, serving.
Called out, cheer umpire overrules, called good.
15 love. Pretty late call on the part of the line judge, but after a little conference.
But now Michael Moe is saying play a let. He got the ball back in play. And they've got it corrected. Yeah, Michael Moe got that ball back in play. So they're going to replay the point. The chair umpire needed to kind of catch up with the sequence there.
So scratch that. So first serve.
I'm going to say this. Good job by Michael Moe. He heard the out call, but he kept playing.
Yeah. 15 love.
Now we're really at 15 love.
Yes.
Aggressive. Moe standing inside the baseline. Noah Rubin, if you notice their court positioning, 4 feet plus behind the baseline there.
30 love.
And the breeze coming out of the north through Stowe Stadium. This stadium very well wind protected from the south and the west. But today, kind of a cool breeze blowing out of the north.
Yeah, much cooler today than it has been throughout the week.
Ooh. Early unforced error off the forehand side from Noah Rubin there. Ball that he normally would handle.
30-15.
Called a fault. Second serve coming. Another forehand error. I'd have to call that unforced as well. Just that Michael Moe covers so well. I mean, you're not going to find many openings in the court to try and penetrate and win the point.
30 all. Michael Moe hanging tough.
That's the case with both of these players. Ooh, my. Called good. Michael Moe looking at the service line. Can't believe it.
40-30.
That one's called long, thankfully.
And another forehand error off the racket of Michael Moe. Rubin holds to pull all even at one first set.
Well, Moe looks like he's decided he's really going to strike out with that forehand. And errors are going to naturally occur. But the positioning of the two, Michael Moe at the baseline or maybe a step inside it. Noah Rubin playing several feet behind the baseline for the most part.
Michael Moe to serve, 1-0, opening set.
What a great dig, what a great dig by Noah Rubin, incredible.
Just incredible athletic ability shown off there by the 3-seed
But that defense won him the point. He got himself back in the point. Mo makes the error. That was just pure effort on the part of Noah Rubin. Extremely well done. Foot fault called. Second serve coming. So what happens is he starts thinking about it. When you get a foot fault called on you, you start thinking about your feet, and it messes up your rhythm. Tough break for Michael Moe. Down love 30 here. Early break opportunity for Noah Rubin.
And now,
double faults come in packages of three. No, and Moe is thinking about that foot fault still. He's got to clear his head.
Pretty sizable second serve, but now love 40 off the backhand error.
Yeah, just a bad spot for Michael Moe here. I don't know, did he call? It's love 40. And ever since that foot fault called, concentration has been broken for Michael Moe. There's another double fault.
And an easy service break. It doesn't really come much easier than that, and certainly something you don't want to do to the three seed Noah Rubin.
Yeah, this is a tough spot for Michael Moe against a player who really isn't going to crack and give him many opportunities. And Noah Rubin, I guarantee you, he senses opportunity right here.
Carolyn Binder alongside Hap Hosh. Glad to have you with us on the Public Media Network locally in Kalamazoo and around the world on USTABoys.com, featuring both the 16 and 18 singles semifinals to start our coverage. We'll transition to doubles finals later this afternoon in our opening match of coverage. It was the top seed in the 16 singles advancing in straight sets over his doubles partner, the 4 seed, John McNally, over Gianni Ross, 6-2 and 7-3 in a tiebreak in the second set. So a little drama in that second set for the top seed, but nonetheless, he advances to the 16 singles final, and the other half of the 16 singles final being figured out on court number 3. Connor Hance, the 9 seed, and unseeded Oliver Crawford splitting sets. And this now our match of coverage on court number 2, the first of 2 semifinals. Noah Rubin, the 3 seed, breaking the serve of the 7 seed, Michael Moe, to take a 2-1 opening set lead.
Yeah, huge opportunity for Noah Rubin. He knows it. It's like a shark smelling blood in the water. And Noah Rubin opens with a service winner. And Michael Moe, if he can clear his head, try and fight his way back, search for a service break in the rest of this first set. But Noah Rubin looks like he's on a mission. And again, a quick error from Michael Moe.
To be too easy. This is a 3 seed.
Noah Rubin keeping his composure and being completely focused, and Michael Moe, ever since the foot fault call, hasn't been able to get himself dialed in again. Again, an error on the second ball from Michael Moe. This is the thing about experience. Noah Rubin's been here before many times. Michael Moe has not.
Rubin, the reigning junior Wimbledon champion, and no stranger to Kalamazoo and Stowe Stadium. This is his third consecutive single semifinal appearance. And you mentioned at the onset of the broadcast the level of maturity in Noah Rubin seemed to take a step up, and that focus is just razor sharp this week.
Yeah, the difference right now is the focus between the two players. Noah Rubin is dialed in, and Michael Moe is trying to find himself again. And it's just second ball errors from Michael Moe. And
game Rubin, hold Rubin, and 3-1, the first set lead for the 3-seed Noah Rubin, cruising early in this first set.
Yeah, and unless Michael Moe can kind of clean things up, and holding serve would be a step in that direction here. He's only down one service break, but you just sense Noah Rubin knows how to get this done.
Yeah, right now at this point, one service break seems monumental mm-hmm. to Michael Moe.
Yep. And the errors are all coming from Michael Moe.
Love 15.
And Noah Rubin's smart enough to know I'm going to keep the ball between the lines.
And don't do anything silly.
And I'm going to let my opponent break down for me. And that's exactly what he's going to do. Ooh, that one just floated long.
15-0.
I think this is a critical hold for Michael Moe. If he can hold here, he's got a chance to kind of get himself sorted out and back into the set. If he doesn't, this could be a runaway for Noah Rubin. Yeah, good to have a big serve in your arsenal. When he needs it, Michael Moe can dial up massive velocity with his first serve. Twice in a row.
40-15.
Three great first serves in a row by Moe. Called out. Real aggressive with that second ball. But in this sequence, Moe has had an epidemic of second ball errors. Another great first serve from Moe. That one's long, definitely.
Michael Moe does indeed hold 2-3, still down a service break though, but a leap in the confidence of Michael Moe from his last service game to this one.
Yeah, and this has to help him, and it looks like he just decided, I'm going to go open up and hit my first serves with everything I've got and just take my chances. I think we have a award presentation going on.
Yeah, we'll step aside for the award presentation.
Oh, Oliver Crawford in that 16 semi went down again, and he's limping. There's an ankle issue, I believe, with Oliver Crawford in that 16 semi.
In sixth place in boys 18, the runner-up from Feden, Taylor Fritz of Rancho Santa Fe, California. Sixth place.
Taylor Fritz also suffering an ankle injury during this tournament.
The winner in TN, Francis Tiafoe of College Park.
I thought it was Tiafoe.
Fifth place, Francis Tiafoe.
We understand that that's part of the logistics changes, some of the format changes to this year's tournament. They feature a separate feed-ins bracket that actually will truly name a fifth and sixth place, and that match, so it's basically an extra match within the feed-ins bracket, and that featured Taylor Fritz and Francis Tiafo, and it's the sixth seed Francis Tiafo that beat Taylor Fritz, so fifth and sixth place respectively there, and they just awarded those.
Here we have Noah Rubin up 15 love.
Rubin up 15 love in 3-2 in the opening set.
Oh, Michael Moe again, just walking away, shaking his head. Held his serve, but hasn't found an answer on Noah Rubin's serve at all.
30 love.
Big forehand by Moe, but Rubin covers it. Not many players could have even touched that ball. Caught the line. Oh, into the feet, tried to pick it up off the court. The defensive skills of Noah Rubin on display there. I'm going to say this about the boys 16 semi. Oliver Crawford may be unseated, but he deserves to be in that semifinal. Young man is playing extremely good tennis.
That match going on court number 3 just into the third and final set. 1-0 for the 9 seed Connor Hance.
Michael Moe showing his court coverage capability.
And Rubin holds again with relative ease.
Yep.
4-2 opening set for the 3 seed.
And that sends a message to Michael Moe that he's going to have to hold his own serve and hope to get to a tiebreak, because Rubin hasn't really been challenged on his serve.
Not really at all. And now the 7 seed down 2-4, down a service break, will serve.
Defensive off the backhand side is Michael Moe. That's the side Rubin is working. That's long. Oh my goodness.
Gets the forehand error from Rubin.
Anyway, thankfully.
15 love.
Michael Moe shot a glance at the line judge during the point. Another good first serve by Michael Moe, but overly aggressive with that second ball. He generated a short return from Rubin, came in and just tried to rip the cover off the ball. When an approach to the open corner and following it into the net might have been the better plan.
15 all.
Rubin calling it out, but the line judges say it was in.
30-15. Noah Rubin's still chatting with the chair umpire about that call.
Again, the way they're structured with these line umpires, that sideline judge is looking all the way down the court through the net. That ball's long.
40-15.
crowd filling into the stadiums here for this boys 18 singles semifinal. We also have a boys 16 semifinal going on court number 3. Tournament director Michael Riley walking around the crowd, shaking hands, kissing babies. I'm just joking about that. But he looks in good spirits today. Michael Moe is serving extremely well.
Yeah, that has really, except for the one game a couple of service games ago where the footfall was called, the little lapse in concentration there, it seems like he's regained that now. 3-4 opening set. And it's Noah Rubin who is just a tad shaky on that last game with a couple of questionable line calls, and you can see that shake his focus just a bit, but he's still up a service break and in good position here in the first set.
Now, Noah Rubin really focused. I mean, the old Noah Rubin on that line call might have gotten into an extended conversation with the chair umpire, but here he made his point and then walked over to the other side and resumed play. Impressive court presence by Noah Rubin.
Carolyn Binder alongside Hap Hosh. Glad you're with us on the Public Media Network and USTAboys.com, featuring a boys 16 singles this morning in the semifinals, the other 16 semifinal in a third set between the 9 seed Connor Hance and unseeded Oliver Crawford.
And Hance is up 1-0 in that third set.
And now Noah Rubin serving on court 2, 4-3 opening set.
Called wide, and now Rubin's contesting that call, and it sure looked good. He's talking to Michael Moe, asking, you know, for confirmation. Again, this is that situation where in the past it would really bother Noah Rubin. Second serve coming. That's wide. Saw that land wide. I'm going to tell you, Carolyn, players at this level, college players and junior players at this level, they pretty much know when the ball comes off their strings.
Yeah.
And 90% of their shots, whether it's in or not, they know. There are that very small percentage of balls that are so close that you don't know. And that's the situation we find ourselves in, is that those balls, with line judges and the players used to making their own calls. That's why there is a chair umpire here. In every single match at the Nationals, there is a chair umpire.
Yeah. Love 15, or excuse me, 15 all.
Mm-hmm.
It was Love 15 to start. Talked with head referee Darryl Davies yesterday, and he talked about the progression of before in the tournament years ago, they featured roving referees, mm-hmm. and that's really hard to keep control of a match when they're just checking in on certain courts.
Oh, Michael Moe, unbelievably athletic overhead. But most junior tournaments feature the roving referee, and that's
exactly
what they're used to.
How does that work?
Oh, they have two, maybe three referees, and they rove indiscriminately around all of the matches, just watching things, correcting if they have to. And if there's a dispute, sometimes they call for, you know, a line judge or someone to be a match referee. That's kind of an extreme case where you have to bring someone in to do that. But this is the feature of the Nats at the Zoo, where there's a chair umpire moderating, so to speak, all of these matches.
30 all.
Noah Rubin taking his time, waiting for the tennis ball to get back. Big serve generates an error.
40-30.
Yeah, looking at Noah Rubin, you don't expect he serves as big as he does.
That goes back to the mechanics that you talked about.
Extremely efficient mechanics for Noah Rubin. Change of slice backhands from both players. Drop shot. Rubin will get there and hit the winner.
What a shot by Noah Rubin. And showing off again the athletic ability and court coverage that he has despite his size. Those legs are quick.
He's an extremely quick player. And when next time you get a chance to watch him serve, you know, we talk, he's not 6'6 like some of the players in this tournament, but look at his leg compression. He generates his power from his legs. And Michael Moe, the taller player, has relied on his big serve, and he's going to need it here again.
Michael Moe serving now to stay in this opening set down 3-5.
Generates a rare error from Rubin. Rubin has been really clean today. He's been playing, not taking too many chances unless it's a good opening and makes sense. That was long, but the volley goes long. Rubin walks away. If he had not won that point, he would have had a comment for the service line judge.
15-all.
Can see the mark from here. But again, to his credit, he just plays the ball. Called long. 30-15. Michael Moe relying on his big serve. He's trying to generate easy points with this big serve, but he hasn't found a way to challenge Noah Rubin's serve yet. Oh, and a miss hit forehand again from Michael Moe.
30-all.
Off a ball that was just sitting there, but swinging so extremely hard, Michael Moe framed that forehand. Moe looking at the chair umpire on the fault call. Rubin, 40-30. Important game for Moe. If he drops this service game,
you're out of the set.
Yeah, it's set Rubin, and Rubin will open the second set on his own serve.
40-30.
That puts extra pressure on this service game for Michael Moe. Huge serve by Michael Moe.
Followed up by a huge forehand winner for the 7 seed, Michael Moe, staying in the set with a service hold down 4-5. And now his next step is to maybe try and find a way to break the serve of Noah Rubin, but that's been a tall task.
he hasn't really found the answer yet, but he gives himself another opportunity with that hold, and he's got to find something that he can exploit on Noah Rubin's serve, and I'm not sure there is anything. Rubin is serving extremely well, and then he's backing it up with great baseline groundstroke play. So
the three seed, Noah Rubin, up 5-4 opening set as coverage continues of the boys' 18 single semifinal. This morning we started with half of the 16s bracket. The top seed, John McNally, advancing in straight sets over the four seed and his doubles partner, 6-2 and 7-3 in the tiebreak second set. Listened to a little bit of the interview of John McNally after the match, and he said, "I'm excited because I'm moving to the final, but not ecstatic because I beat my brother," so to say, calling Gianni Ross's brother. Of course, those two top seeds in the doubles bracket.
Update in that boys 16 semifinal on court three. It is unseeded Oliver Crawford up 2-1 in the third set. A tremendous showing by the unseeded Oliver Crawford.
Nat, the other half of the 16 semifinal. Here it's Noah Rubin serving up 5-4 opening set.
Here's Noah Rubin, whose serve so far has been impenetrable. That was a let for serve, so a second serve is coming. Forced error from Noah Rubin there.
Love 15.
I mentioned earlier, Rubin has played an extremely clean set. Not a lot of silliness, not a lot of forced creativity. Just rock solid on just about every point. In that backhand corner of Michael Mull. Ball after ball. You heard the crowd gasp on that forehand from Mull. Called out.
Love 30. A battle though on that point between the three and the seven seed.
That ooh from the crowd was justified on the forehand from Michael Mull because he blistered it. Michael Mull, again, talking about the service line. He just can't believe it, and it's true. I mean, he's just got to keep playing. Play every ball and don't worry about what he thinks of an in-out call. Just play every ball.
15-30. Oh. Thought it was a service
that
ace.
Wide. Now Ruben's talking, but that ball was wide. Mo acknowledged it and kind of pointed. It was wide. And that one, we've got a great vantage point up here on the tower, and that ball was wide. But this is what used to rattle Rubin. Let's see how he handles his second serve.
Safe.
Nicely. pulled that forehand wide. Is this the opportunity Michael Moe's been trying to get to? Yeah. Two all in that third set, boys 16 semi between Crawford and Hance. Okay. Ruben might be pressing a little bit here after that line call dispute. What a serve, but a defensive return from Mull. Unbelievable forehands. Mo runs around the backhand to take the forehand again, but nets it.
Nets the forehand. Another great rally here in this battle. 30-40. Taking some extra time to mull this one over. One break point fought off, one to go.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
And an unbelievable point over on court three.
Crawford fell twice when was able to recover and keep the ball in play. Oh.
Break Mo.
There's the break.
And we're at five all, opening set. What we thought could not be broken was the service game of Noah Rubin. And what do you know? Michael Mo came up with the way to do it. So now on the first service break of Noah Rubin, Michael Mo will have a serve now to take the lead in this opening set.
Okay. He wants to avoid a foot fault call. Interesting. Slice backhands from both players, just testing each other. Oh, got it.
Got the line.
Landed on the line.
15 love.
Noah Rubin just walks over to the ad court. He saw the ball clearly in front of him. Big crowd on hand for this boys 18 single semifinal.
And a second foot fault called on Michael Mo.
Yep, here, and see how he handles it. Noah Rubin penetrating two-handed backhand to the forehand corner of Mull.
15-all.
Massive serve by Michael Mo. Goes back to the open corner.
30-15.
Let call,
yeah. Let called.
Thank you. aggressive with that forehand was Noah Rubin.
40-15.
Great serve, better return. Kind of a flat two-handed backhand from Michael Moe. Pretty much a defensive.
Moe game holds. 6-5, opening set, a little turnaround for the 7 seed here. And now coming off of a service break, Noah Rubin, imperative that he hold his concentration and get through this service game to force a first set tiebreak.
Yep, and the difference here is Michael Moe has collected himself after that early foot fault call.
And we will direct our attention to the media tower as there's more award announcements to be made. Duncan and Logan Smith being awarded the champion and runner-up in the feed-ins division.
It is 4-2 Hants in that third set over Oliver Crawford, boys 16 semifinal on court number 3.
And here it's Noah Rubin on court 2 in the boys 18 semifinal, and he's trying to serve to force a first set tiebreak.
Nice wide serve by Noah Rubin. First time he's shown that, really, from the deuce court. He had Michael Moe completely stretched out.
15, love.
Positioning the ball, kids, properly.
Fifteen all.
Pressure mounting on Noah Rubin's serve. He delivers a bomb. Generates a short ball he puts away easily.
30-15.
Called out. Rubin took a look at the chair umpire. Calmly kicks his second serve in.
And we are well on the way to a first set tiebreak.
Not totally unexpected.
Particularly between these two opponents.
There we are.
There it is. A Rubin hold, 6-all opening set, and a first set tiebreak. Michael Moe had a lapse in concentration, a couple of foot faults called in this first set on his service game, but since then he's kind of gathered himself
very nicely, actually. Yeah. And it, if there was a hitch in this first set for Michael Moe, it was immediately after the first foot fault call.
And now he will serve to start the 7-point first set tiebreak.
He'll get one serve and then two serves each from there on out. Just climbing over the net was that backhand from Ruben. Ooh, overhit that.
Huge forehand.
Mm-hmm. It's 5-2 Hants in that third set over Oliver Crawford.
And one love first set tiebreak for Noah Ruben.
And look at the court positioning again. No, Michael Moe is playing most of these points on the baseline, standing on the baseline or slightly inside. Noah Ruben, 3+ feet.
Now chatting
pass.
With...
Oh, we've got a dead tennis ball, I think.
Or at least chatting about the tennis balls, but he's satisfied with the two in his hand. And he's up 1-0 mm-hmm. in the tiebreak.
Tremendous defensive get by Ruben. Oh, forehand error.
1-1. Not only showing wheels on that defensive get, but some wingspan that we don't expect to see. He really used all of his arm length to get to that forehand. 1-1, 7-set. 7-point set tiebreak.
Big serve down the middle, long for Ruben. Oh, a nice wide slice serve generates a framed ball.
2-1, Ruben.
A couple of times, Michael Moe has found himself framing the ball off that forehand side so badly he's hitting it all the way over to the backside court complex. Kind of looked like a pitching wedge there, Carolyn, putting it in golf terms that you'll recognize.
Like Sky, that one a mile high.
One of your pitches to the pin.
Yeah, from about 100 yards out.
Yeah. That's about, well, that ball flew.
Yeah.
80 plus yards.
Yeah.
Oh, another frame job.
3-1, Ruben.
That is a... unfortunate error for Michael Moe. Third consecutive fault for Michael Moe.
That's science.
It's unbelievable how that happens so often. Tremendous forehands from Ruben.
Pounding uh-huh. the backhand to set that forehand error up. 4-1.
Yeah, right now the turning point in this tiebreaker was that double fault by Moe from the ad court. I mean, just rushed himself a little bit. Noah Ruben again sensing he's in charge and he's 3 points away from this first set. Got it.
Service ace. 2 points away now from this first set.
Changing on the sixes.
And I have to agree with you that double fault in this tiebreak really was in the head of Michael Moe. He's in a hole, 1-5 in the tiebreak over on court three. A quick peek, it's 30 all. Connor Hance up 5-2, and now 40-30 match point for the 9 seed in the 16 singles. He will meet John McNally, who won in straight sets over Gianni Ross earlier, and it's looking really good for the 9 seed here to advance to that 16 singles final.
Mm-hmm.
Back on court two, Noah Rubin serving up 5-1 in the tiebreak. Now,
Hance closes his match in the 16 semi.
So a 1-9 will be the 16 singles final. We'll have that for you tomorrow on our final day of coverage here from the 2014 Nationals in Kalamazoo.
Connor Hance to the tower.
Michael Moe serving down 1-6 in the first set tiebreak.
Good safe play by Noah Rubin. Doesn't have to do anything crazy here. Gets the error.
And there it is, the error. And the first set in the tiebreak to Noah Rubin. And just dominated in that tiebreak was Michael Moe.
Mm-hmm. Now they're announcing the other boys 18 single semifinal. Court three, Altamirano, Kozlov.
And how about this talent on center court between Michael Moe, Noah Rubin, Colin Altamirano, and Stefan Kozlov about to take to the court?
Big time players in the 18 singles all taking center court at the same time.
And it's Noah Rubin with the first set and half of the boys' 18 singles semifinal, the 3 seed. No stranger to the semifinal rounds in Kalamazoo. Been here now a third consecutive year. And as we both mentioned, noticeably different mental edge that Noah Rubin possesses.
Mm-hmm.
And just solely focused on that final round tomorrow, taking the first set through some adversity, though, the 3 seed.
Well, Michael Moe is a great player.
Yeah.
Now, this is Michael Moe's. I believe Coach Riley talked to us about Michael Moe's first experience here at Kalamazoo. But that might be the difference, is that Noah Rubin has been here. As Coach had said, he's had disappointment here. But he's had experience on these center courts with the big crowds. Michael Moe, his first experience in Kalamazoo, a great athletic player, no question about that. But the experience edge has to go to Noah Rubin.
Without a doubt, and it'll be Rubin to serve up a set to start the second. Love 15. How big would it be here for Michael Moe to come out of the gate in the second with a service break?
It would be huge. I mean, he needs something good to happen to get him get on top and play from in front. Frustration seen in Noah Rubin. First visible signs of frustrations, really, other than a couple of mild discussions about line calls.
Love 30.
Opportunity for Michael Moe right here. And he gets to play off the second serve. Aggressive with that return. Changing speeds with his forehand. Backhand floats long.
15-30.
Bomb from Noah Rubin called long. Good.
Down the sideline, 30-40. 30 all, excuse me. Just getting ahead of myself.
Yeah, ready? This is going to be a battle. And really, it's can Michael Moe continue to hang point after point with Noah Rubin?
Having to go to a second serve quite often is Noah Rubin.
That just floated wide on him.
30-40.
The wind changed out of the south for just a second here in Stowe Stadium. Rubin hit that forehand without a lot of pace to it, and the wind pushed it an inch wide. Great pass, almost a great volley by
and
Rubin.
What do you know, the 7 seed with the service break of Noah Rubin, and that's got to be a shot of confidence on the arm of Michael Moe.
Yeah, maybe, just maybe, Noah Rubin kind of let down his intensity just slightly, having put that first set away in the tiebreaker, but kaboom, Michael Moe gets a service break out of the gate. He will serve, and if he can consolidate this and get up 2-0, might create the momentum he needs to close out the second set.
Carolyn Binder alongside Hap Hosh. Glad you're with us on the Public Media Network and USTAboys.com. We had the 16 single semifinals to open our coverage, and those brackets are set. The final tomorrow will be the top seed, John McNally, and the 9 seed, Connor Hant, surviving a 3-set scare from unseeded Oliver Crawford. But do not forget that name, Oliver Crawford. He will certainly be a presence here in Kalamazoo throughout the years. Now we've transitioned to the boys' singles semifinals, and it's Noah Rubin on court 2 taking the first set in a tiebreak, 7-1, and getting set to take the court on court 3, Colin Altamirano, the 5 seed, and Stefan Kozloff, the 4 seed. Michael Moe up a break to start the second set.
That forehand got away from Michael Moe.
Love 15.
Called good. Rubin taking a look, and he can't believe it. 15-0.
15-0, yep.
Another good first serve by Michael Moe, but a tentative backhand. Maybe that's where that sliced backhand as an approach might have been a nice thing there, but he tentative two-hand backhand he dumped in the net. His backhand is very flat.
15-30.
pickup by Mo. On no man's land. Ooh, very upset.
30 all. Good point, though, between those two. Both showing off their athletic abilities. 30 all.
Good defense and transition to offense very quickly for Noah Rubin. He had that forehand volley that he just dumped. 40-30. Mo gives a fist pump to somebody in the crowd. It's a good crowd on hand for this. There's room for more. Another good first serve by Michael Mo. Fits that ball just inside the line.
Service hold consolidates the service break, does Michael Mo, and now two games to love. Second set.
That's what he needed. Maybe Michael Mo has generated a little Mo momentum. I'm sorry about that, but it's something he needed. I mean, he had a little struggle in the middle of the first set, got himself to a tiebreak. Rubin holds fairly easily in that tiebreak to win the set, but now Michael Mo up 2-0 in the second set.
Are you trying to say his mojo is working?
Could be. Ooh, call, late call, but wide. Michael Mo looking to the chair umpire for a correction. And we had a confusion on the score again.
15 love.
Oh, a rare double fault for Noah Rubin. 15 all. And the breeze really hasn't been a factor this week, but today there's definitely something coming out of the north.
Huge forehand return by Michael Mo.
Yeah.
Not letting the breeze affect him there.
Well, it's at his back right now, but he didn't need it. That was a crushing forehand.
15-30.
Oh, just crawls over the net. That tentative backhand from Michael Mo. A frustrated Noah Rubin now for the first time, really. I think feeling the pressure. He's down 0-2 in the second set.
And a couple of break points to fight off here for Noah Rubin. Easy put away for Noah Rubin, 30-40.
That time a swinging forehand volley to the opening for Noah Rubin. Massive topspin by Rubin. Just couldn't dig that.
Fights both break points off to deuce.
both players being extended deep into the corners on many of these points. Another mind-boggling forehand from Michael Mull.
Third break point for Noah Rubin here.
Oh, he's going to get there. Oh, it didn't clear.
And another 3-0. Break. 3-0. Whoa. Yeah, and then the mental toughness of Noah Rubin being tested here in the second set.
Yep, he's staring at a possible third set with Michael Mull. A more confident Michael Mull.
Yeah. And still there's a possibility of some shakiness we've seen in Michael Mull come out in this second set, but so far his game in the second set been nearly flawless.
Well, I mean, he hasn't experienced that foot fault call that kind of derailed him a little bit in the middle of the first set, but since that time it took him two games to kind of sort himself out after that foot fault call. But he did it, and he got to a first set tiebreaker that he ended up losing to Noah Rubin. Actually extremely strong in that tiebreak.
Yeah.
But now Michael Mull finds himself up 3-0 in the second, just needs to hold serve, and he'll finish with a split, and then they'll take this battle into a third set is what it's beginning to look like.
Let's look ahead to the possibility of a third set. Who holds the advantage at this point if this does go to a third set?
I'd have to give the edge to Noah Rubin because of his experience here in Kalamazoo. As you've mentioned before, he is the Wimbledon Juniors champion from this year. So he's played on grass, obviously, a
right.
different surface, but just the experience of playing in a stadium environment under pressure. Slight edge to Noah Rubin if we go 3.
Carolyn Binder alongside Hap Hosh. Glad you're with us on Public Media Network and USTAboys.com. Michael Mull, the 7 seed, serving up 3-0 in the second set.
And another massive first serve by Michael Mull. It's really been his saving grace in this match, is his ability to dial up his serve and get not so many aces, but generating errors, service return errors like that, 2 in a row.
30 love in the blink of an eye.
Mm-hmm. If he can stay in that zone, he can cruise through this second set.
40 love.
This time, yeah, Rubin take a look at the side, the service line judge, but dejectedly walks over to ad court. Okay, after 3 first serves in a row, that's the first one missed in the service game. Short ball. Oh, Michael Mull let his center of gravity get high. He was going to follow that ball to the net.
40-15.
Another way of saying he let his butt get up on him and he dumped the ball on the net. 40-15. Don't give Noah Rubin too many chances to fight back because he'll do it. But another big first serve when he needed it. Michael
Mull. First serves the story of that service game for Michael Mull. Now, 4 games to love, and we talk about what these certain scores look like on the scoreboard. And even though you're up a set, if you're Noah Rubin, 0-4 looks really bad.
Yeah, and for Noah Rubin, even if he drops his second set, he's trying to find something that he can hang on to take into a third set, trying to generate a little more momentum for himself.
Drama.
Starts with holding serve.
Drama brewing on court 2, 15 love. Backhand error, 15 all.
I just heard an ole from court number 3. That must have come from Colin Altamirano.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, just pulled it wide. For whatever reason, this started in the first service game of the second set for Noah Rubin, where maybe he let his intensity drop just a hair, and he hasn't been able to find it since.
30-15.
Oh, net court ball cleared and landed in. That's going to go... Ooh. Landed in.
That
oh,
was...
no. Chair umpire just ruled it long. Yeah. Here we're having the discussion. Mo doesn't believe it. Chair umpire very late with the correction.
Right. And that's got to be frustrating for the players, knowing the line judges that are there. Mm-hmm. I mean, for both sides, just the fact that it was here, so late.
Here we have our first extended conversation. Both players getting involved in it right now.
Chair umpire did make the call that the ball was out. Michael Moe pleading his case. Noah Rubin was in on the conversation, but has since
backed
away. I think
it might be question whether they're going to play a let or a point is awarded, because the ball is out. Rubin got a ball in. Moe stopped playing, I think, right?
And he wants... So he's fighting for the let. Is that what to replay the point? We can't hear what's going on, but just based on...
Yeah, this chair umpire is not audible. So, it's unfortunate. And frustrated Rubin a little bit there, but clearly a fairly heated exchange. There's an approach. Long with the lob. The wind pushed that long.
30-40, and Noah Rubin's still chatting. It looks as if they just replayed the point.
I'm interpreting. I think that's what they were trying to get to. Unfortunately, this chair umpire is... he's not Sally.
Break point facing Noah Rubin.
Long with that forehand. That's a frustration forehand.
Deuce.
For Noah Rubin. Altamirano up a service break to start their boys 18 singles semifinal. 1-0, Altamirano. Oh, good penetrating forehand by Michael Moe.
Break point once again facing Noah Rubin. Fights it off, back to deuce.
Ooh, wild forehand return. Advantage, yeah, Rubin.
And now hold point for Noah Rubin.
Earlier in the tournament, Rubin had been called for a couple of foot faults himself.
Yep.
Nice backhand from, again, that flat two-handed backhand from Michael Moe is kind of breaking down a little bit here.
But the story of the second set, that service hold, the first for Noah Rubin here in the middle set, but a little momentum for him that he hasn't seen here.
He wanted to hold serve here and just start anything if he can. He's down two service breaks. And for Michael Moe, keep up that really good, strong first service game he's been having. Good power, you know, getting a high percentage of those first serves in. If he does that and holds, he'll win the set.
Carolyn Binder alongside Hap Hosh. Glad to have you with us on the Public Media Network and USTAboys.com featuring the boys' 18 singles semifinal rounds. We started with the 16 semifinals, and those singles brackets are decided. The final will be the top seed, John McNally, against the 9 seed, Connor Hance. And here with both semifinal rounds going, we're featuring the 3 seed Noah Rubin out of Rockville Center, New York, up a set but down big in the second, 1-4, just able to hold on to his service game. In the last game against the 7 seed Michael Moe out of Temple Hills, Maryland, over it's on court number 3.
One all
with the defending champion Colin Altamirano, the 5 seed, against Stefan Kozlov, the 4 seed. And we'll see 3 out of these 4 players featured later this afternoon in the 18 doubles championship in Altamirano, Rubin, and Kozlov.
Yeah, it's back-to-back service breaks to start that other boys' 18 singles semifinal.
Again, a huge first serve in for Michael Moe.
Yeah, if he keeps that up, he should be able to close this second set. Generates a short ball, but stays back and nets this, the second forehand. That ball was so short in that initial forehand. And it looks like he should have followed that to the net and looked for a volley.
15 all.
Again, it's that flat backhand.
Yep. 15-30.
This could get interesting as a second set here.
And
just
continued with the forehand
unforced errors. Just unforced, complete unforced errors off the forehand side for Michael Moe. Just really trying to hit ground stroke winners when all he needs is to fit the ball inside the lines. And in these cases, these balls are so short from Rubin. Move forward and hit a volley or an overhead. It's almost a gift game he's giving Rubin. Rubin's going to get there. Floats long, but a real casual service game from Michael Moe at possibly the worst time. The wind helped that ball stay in from Noah Rubin. Again, Rubin's balls are landing inside the service box. Oh, and then a transition to offense for Rubin, but he nets it.
Break points fought off to deuce.
Yeah, but there's a passive approach to Michael Moe right now that I don't understand. Noah Rubin hitting into the wind, and his balls are landing so incredibly short. And we know Michael Moe is a tremendously talented net player from his doubles play. He's relying on that massive first serve.
Hold point.
We're staring at a third consecutive service break in that other boys' 18. Oh, again, a wild forehand from Moe.
Back to Deuce.
Michael Moe.
He's coming up with that big serve when he needs it. Mm-hmm.
And as long as he can keep doing that, great. But it's just an odd decision-making, particularly in this service game, of letting very short balls from Ruben, letting them go and just content to play, you know, smashing tennis from the baseline. Great second serve by Mo.
Mo holds.
Just relying on that serve.
Yeah, 5-1, second set, and we are that much closer to a third and decisive mm-hmm. final set here in half the boys' 18 semifinals. Carolyn Binder alongside Hap Hosh. Glad you're with us as we are into semifinal and final weekend here at the USTA Boys Championships at the Zoo. Noah Rubin serving down 1-5 and a big spinning serve there. The crowd applause coming from court 3, but a good point over there between the other half of the boys' 18 semifinal.
Oh, that got away from Rubin.
15 all.
Boy, Michael Mull would love to break serve to close this set and open the third set on his own serve. That's what Noah Rubin is trying to fight off right here. Called a fault late.
That would mean whole new ball game here on court 2.
Ooh, that backhand got away from Ruben, too. 15-30. Long. Over hit the forehand.
30 all.
Big forehand from Rubin. Another one. Oh, it went over. It's going to go long.
40-30. And a hold point here for Noah Rubin. Down 1-5 in the second set. Mo fights it off to Deuce.
Passing shot on the other side. Oh my goodness. Altamirano trying to get the third consecutive service break over there in that other boys 18.
He's going to get there.
Tremendous reflexes by Noah Rubin. Michael Mo put the ball right at his body.
And here's the situation Noah Rubin did not want to be in. Service broke for the set. comes up with a huge serve when he needed it.
Yep. Third consecutive service break in that other boy's 18.
2-1 the advantage for Altamirano. Service break City on court 3. And now Ruben will look to hold. Here on court 2, he's fought off a few break points.
This is big to hold here.
Yeah.
Oh, Ruben's going to get there. Oh, that's not going to do it.
That's too easy for Noah Ruben, the winner. And the service hold 2-5 now. Second set, but now Michael Moe can serve out for the second set, force the third set.
Real casual with that lob attempt from Michael Moe. One of the things, you know, Coach Riley talked about a little bit about with Michael Moe and his doubles partner Francis Tiafoe is he described it as light switch tennis, and he takes a point off here or there, and that's part of the learning curve, I think, because Noah Ruben isn't going to take a single point off, no matter what the score is.
Noah Ruben has surprisingly struggled through the second set, but you see the mental aspect of the game come into play for him at this point, and he even faced adversity in that last game, overcame 3 or 4 break points to hold his serve. He knew he had to, and he got it done.
Yeah, I mean, that's, you know, maybe that's the experience factor I was mentioning earlier, is that Noah Ruben understands that every single point in a match like this matters.
Yeah.
And even if you're playing defense and you feel out of it, he's going to keep trying. Michael Moe on that last lob attempt, just far too casual.
Michael Moe to serve now, up 5-2 in the second set. A service hold here would force a third set in half of this boys' 18 singles semifinal. And service break City over on court 3. It's 2-1 Altamirano in the opening set with Stefan Kozlov.
Oh, Michael Moe sets up an easy ball with that serve. Instead of moving forward and hitting the overhead, he bounces it and tries to hit the big forehand off a high bounce. I just don't understand why you don't move forward and make either a volley or an overhead on that ball. Nice sequence there for Moe. Big serve, forehand cross court to the opening. Michael Moe has relied on his big service game in this set, and he needs to here.
Does so there, 30-15.
Oh, what a bomb. Good. Absolute blistered first serve from Michael Moe.
40-15.
Another one. Ruben gets that in play. But then that's a backhand.
Game and second set to Michael Moe. With relative ease, 6-2, a couple of service breaks of Noah Ruben, and he cruises in that middle set. We'll take a
10-minute break between sets, yep. And then we'll rejoin the action.
All right, so we'll step aside and be back. This is USTA Tennis on the Public Media Network and ustaboys.com. Carolyn Binder rejoining you high atop Stowe Stadium on the campus of Kalamazoo College for continued coverage of the boys' 18 singles semifinal. And we've reached a third and decisive set with the 3 seed Noah Rubin and the 7 seed Michael Moe. Noah Rubin will serve to open the final set. I'm joined by Hap Hosh, Executive Director of Public Media Network, in the broadcast tower, and a double fault to start the opening service game for Noah Rubin here in the third set.
Inauspicious start, but I mean the nerves for both players. They're as nervous now as they were to start the match. Float long. I like Rubin's
30.
I like Rubin's decision there on that ad court first serve just to kick it in. But he can't play passive. Michael Moe has found himself.
Yeah. Highly competitive first set went to a tie break. Noah Rubin dominated 7-1 in the tie break. And then it was Michael Moe coming out of the gate. A couple of consecutive service breaks for him. And he took the second set 6-2. Now Noah Rubin struggling out of the gate here on his service game.
Forehand error.
15-30.
Interesting if Noah Rubin continues to try and work the backhand side of Michael Moe. Michael Moe with that really flat two-hand backhand has had, you know, sporadic errors pop up on him on that side where he has a huge forehand available to him on the other. And that was hard to the tee. Changing the paces is Noah Rubin. There's that flat backhand.
Yep, 30 all.
And that cord.
And there again you see Michael Moe keeping his butt up on that, mm-hmm. creating the flat angle and the netted backhand.
Well, it's all about leg compression, center of gravity, getting your racket below the ball. But Michael Moe's two-handed back is just basically flat. Oh, that's going to sail long.
40-30, and Noah Rubin passing the early mm-hmm. test here on his service game.
Here's Stefan Kozlov's father from the crowd over that other match. Interesting change of pace, playing middle third of the court, just looking for an opening. That goes long. Wind is at Noah Rubin's back, and once he lifted that ball the slightest bit, the wind was going to push it long.
At the break, both players allowed to talk with their coaches. What do you think each side said going into this third set?
Well, for Michael Moe, he already did what he needed to do, was get his composure back after a foot fault. And I'm guessing Noah Rubin's coach is saying, try to work the backhand side of Moe and keep him off of that forehand that he's actually started to hit aggressively. There's that forehand.
Yeah.
Moe runs around the backhand. Boy, Rubin moving forward. Good choice.
Rubin holds, but not after before a fight from Michael Moe. A challenging service game to open this third set mm-hmm. for Noah Rubin.
Yeah. Good gut check for Noah Rubin there.
Yeah, because something changed in that second set for Noah Rubin. We've been talking about the maturity of his mental game and that mental edge that he brings each and every match now this year. The defending Wimbledon Juniors champion has just essentially been untested for the most part through this tournament, overcoming some adversity through the field, but solidly into the semifinal round. And then he comes up against Michael Moe. He gets through the first set in a tiebreak and then just kind of fell flat in that second set.
Well, he had his service broken immediately in that second set, and there was just a slight drop in focus and energy. And that's natural. It happens to tennis players all the time that win a first set, they start the second set, and they don't quite have everything as lined up as they did. And that one service break kind of opened the door for Michael Moe.
Service hold to start the second set for Noah Rubin. Here's Michael Moe serving down 0-1, third set.
Net cord did not go over. I can't help but point out how important psychologically it is that Noah Rubin is playing from in front in this third set.
Always looks better.
It's on the line. Ooh, Rubin wanted to come forward, but then retreated back to the baseline. Called wide.
30 love.
But if Noah Rubin can continue to hold his serve, he'll be always ahead on that scorecard in the important third set. Always adds a little extra pressure to the server who's playing from behind on the scoreboard. Good breeze right now blowing out of the north. Michael Moe's back, and that helped push that ball on. Player with a flat two-hand backhand with the wind at their back, the ball has a tendency to sail on them.
30-15.
Michael Moe has shown a really good slice one-handed backhand and might go to that a little bit, even though the wind is at his back. But seems to be struggling with that flat two-handed backhand. Rubin trying to pick on it. Oh, he was right there to make the volley, but dumped it.
30 all.
Well set up by Michael Moe. He put himself in perfect position to finish that point. It's 4-3 Altamirano over Kozlov in that other boys 18 singles semifinal.
That match
late
in its first set.
Call.
Yeah, and a late call here on court two. Third set just underway. Rubin leads 1-0.
Pretty conservative right now. For all that aggression we saw in the second set, both players playing middle third of the court, just looking for an opening. It's like a practice point. They're trying to rally to 100. And then an unforced error, just little tentativeness from Rubin. Michael Moe relying on that big service game. Call to fault. Long with that forehand. Deuce.
Rubin fights off the game point to deuce. Another huge second serve from Michael Moe. He is not backing off at all.
Well, there's an opportunity, particularly at ad court. Michael Moe's serve is generating floating chip returns from Rubin, but Mo is choosing to stay in the baseline rather than play serve and volley. If he moved forward, he would have an easy volley to an open court, but he finds himself in a baseline rally. Wide with the forehand.
Now break point for Noah Rubin.
Huge moment in this third set. I think Michael Mo got maybe a little too passive in this service game.
That'll sneak up on you quick, especially against an opponent like Noah Rubin.
And he gets the bomb, delivers in the box with that massive first serve.
Back to deuce.
There he's at the net. Gets the volley to put away.
Game point. Michael Mo.
Tremendous athleticism with Michael Mo. Might want to find himself at the net more, particularly with the wind at his back and Rubin hitting into the wind. And some of these balls are floating. Look for the big bomb here. No.
Tried for it.
He was going to hook the ball into the body of Rubin. Good choice. Just kick this second one in. Rubin changing the pace. I like it. He gets the error.
Back to deuce.
Smart tennis by Noah Rubin.
Check in with court three quickly. 5-3 Altamirano. Up in the first set, Stefan Kozlov serving, 40-30 over there.
Oh my goodness. No time to be cute.
Break point.
Good, safe execution, but again, Mo found himself at the net with a floater, and that's been available to him this entire service game.
Mo fights off the break point to deuce.
Another excellent first serve by Mo, but he's caught on the baseline again. Wide with
That's
the volley.
Wide. Yeah.
Rubin talking to himself there. He knows he pushed it just wide. He set it up perfectly.
Hold point, Michael Mo.
Oh, Ruben not able to get the lob up.
Michael Moe holds on his opening service game of the final set, not without a struggle, though. The 7 seed at 1-all final set with the 3 seed Noah Rubin.
Not a coincidence that those final 2 points to close the game out for Michael Moe happened at the net. And Rubin is hitting into the wind, and Michael Moe is probably, to his own detriment, decided to play much of that service game from the baseline. But there, he found a way forward and picked off 2 consecutive floaters. Rubin serving at 1-all. It's called long. Rubin looking, but the ball was definitely long.
Colin Altamirano, 2 points away from closing out the opening set on court 3 here on court 2. We're at 1-all in the 3rd set.
Huge crowd on hand this afternoon.
15 love.
Great testament to this community and this tournament.
And it's been great crowds all week long.
Again, Ruben trying to work the backhand corner.
That was down. 30 love.
Altamirano takes the first set and the other boys 18 singles.
So both sides of the bracket will be figured out after the conclusion of these 2 matches. Colin Altamirano, the 5 seed and defending champion, now up a set on Stefan Kozloff, the 4 seed.
Wide. Real intensity brewing on both court 2 and 3 here at Stowe Stadium. That ball was long.
Double fault, Noah Rubin.
Rubin taking a look, but the ball was definitely long.
30-15 now.
You can just feel the tension here in these matches. Again, that kind of flat, defensive, two-handed backhand from Michael Moe. And I'm predicting Noah Rubin is going to try and pound that side.
40-15.
Long with the serve. It's long and wide. Luckily, the sideline judge called it wide. Oh, Rubin had an opening but caught tape.
40-30.
Aggressive step forward by Michael Moe on that second serve there. He found himself well inside the court. We don't have that fancy network technology to graphically display where the players are striking the ball, but Moe definitely... oh, my goodness.
What a shink in the armor of Noah Rubin's service game here.
And he rushed himself. I mean, he missed the first serve, but then he really went very quickly into his motion for a second serve. And I talk to players all the time about, no, take a breath, walk around in a circle, whatever you got to do, get your breathing right before you swing at that second serve. Rubin playing safely inside the lines right now. Yep, ball floated wide. The wind changed on Moe.
Yeah.
It's blowing from the south, and that helped push the ball wide.
That was the tough part of that point. The wind picked up on Michael Moe. Now it's hold point for Noah Rubin.
An exasperated Michael Moe, but again, that flat backhand sails wide, or long, excuse me, for Michael Moe.
Ruben holds now 2-1 final set after the players split sets. And it, in really contrasting fashions, the first two sets played out. A tiebreak to decide the first set went to Noah Ruben.
The trainer has been called, interestingly, to court two for someone, either Ruben or Moe. It looks like it might be Moe.
Yeah, Michael Moe calling the trainer. Michael Moe dominated that second set 6-2, and now a medical timeout for Michael Moe.
And outside of this medical issue, the difference in this third set might be Noah Ruben's ability to generate errors off the backhand side of Michael Moe. Michael Moe has relied on his forehand and his service game. Huge serves and big forehands at opportune times. But where Noah Ruben has been successful is when he can construct a point that features more backhands from Michael Moe. And despite whatever this physical issue is, I think that's the key to Noah Ruben taking this third and final set.
Carolyn Binder alongside Hap Hosh. Glad to have you with us on the Public Media Network locally in Kalamazoo and worldwide on ustaboys.com, featuring the 18 singles semifinals as our coverage on finals weekend rolls along. Taking a peek over at court three, they're in between sets, and it was Colin Altamirano, the 5 seed and defending champion, taking the first set 6-4 from the 4 seed Stefan Kozloff. Of course, Ruben and Kozloff doubles partners, and they will be part of the doubles final that we will bring to you at approximately 1 o'clock. Check that 2:30 for the 18s. The doubles final starts at about 1:30. Of course, those are approximate times, but the special part of this weekend, starting the finals round early with the Saturday doubles final, and that moves us to tomorrow, our final matches of coverage in the 16 singles and 18 singles. Our 16 singles final was set earlier today, and it will be the top seed John McNally taking on the 9 seed Connor Hantz. Of course, we'll bring that to you tomorrow. And both sides of the final bracket for the 18 singles being set here right now as we speak on center courts at Stowe Stadium. And Michael Moe being laid out on the sideline by the trainer. It appears some stretching is going on there. Court number two. He's not aware of any medical issues Michael Moe was suffering from heading into the match.
No.
But things can change in a hurry when you're at this level of competition.
It's not a tremendously hot or humid day.
Right.
Kind of low humidity. But then again, you never really know if the players have pulled something, you know, some kind of, doesn't look like a twisted ankle, some kind of back. We had yesterday's big surprise, Carolyn.
Yes, and I was just going to bring that
issue,
up
yeah.
with the top seed, Jared Donaldson, in the 18 singles bracket, taking on Colin Altamirano. And he was up 4-2, I believe, in the opening set, and he was dominating by all accounts, and he called a medical timeout. He received some treatment on an abdominal strain, and a couple of points later, he called the match, said, hey, I can't go.
Yeah, he had to retire.
Yeah, the shock at Stowe Stadium was palpable as this medical timeout wraps up for Michael Moe, so stay tuned on that. The after effects yet to be seen as Noah Ruben takes back to the court. Michael Moe walks back to his baseline. And it's 2-1, Noah Ruben, final set.
We haven't seen anything, you know, distinctive in Michael Moe that would indicate an injury issue. Well, he's kind of acting like a back issues, kind of stretching there. That might be back spasms.
Back or possibly a hip area.
But Michael Moe's relied on his serve throughout this match, and he needs it here. Again, pretty conservative baseline play from both players. Understanding the importance of this service game. Oh, Mo moving forward, taking the ball out of his feet. Again, that's that cuteness factor. He was going to try a half volley drop volley.
And love 15.
It's a low percentage shot, even for a player as talented as Michael Moe. I can't count the number of times I've seen players attempt that shot in this tournament with very, very low percentage of success. No, Rubin's easily going to get to that. He's got Moe totally defensive right now. Yep.
Love 30.
Yeah, Noah Rubin recognizing with the wind at his back and these short balls landing from Moe. Rubin recognized an opportunity to go on offense, and he took it. Real impressive by Noah Rubin. That big serve that has bailed him out the entire match.
15-30.
But you wonder how long he can rely on that when other parts of his game, specifically that flat two-hand backhand. I just heard an LA from the other court. It has to be Colin Altamirano.
You've seen Mo stretched out a couple of times. How will that affect the apparent
That was long.
Back spasm?
Oh, very late call.
Yeah, very long, very late call. Noah Rubin.
Obviously long. Now Noah Rubin contesting, but that ball was obviously long.
It took a
moment or two for the line judge to make the call, upsetting Noah Rubin. I think we figured out that the issue with Michael Moe is I think he's got some tightness in his back. Oh, that one wild for him, but how did that land in? Oh, framed. I think some nerves are creeping into Michael Moe's groundstroke game here. Big moment for Michael Moe in this third set. Critical moment, down 1-2 to Noah Rubin. Again, a huge crowd on hand here at Stowe Stadium. This must make tournament director Michael Riley extremely happy, this kind of turnout on a Saturday afternoon.
Oh, and a double fault.
He went big with the second ball. I just don't understand it.
Rubin now up 3-1. That was a crucial hold for Michael Moe and unable to put it away. Michael Moe, the 7th seed, receiving some medical treatment before the service game started. I have to believe it's some sort of back spasm or muscle spasm in the back, and you saw it affect his service game.
That was a choice by Michael Mull. I cannot understand that choice at all. Got there, he'll put that away. Again, Michael Mull finds himself at the net and wins the point.
Love 15.
But the choice Michael Mull made at break point, hitting a second serve from the ad court.
Yeah.
The choice to hit a second first serve, that may be the story of this third set. I just don't understand. I don't think most coaches will understand that choice either. Ruben playing smart percentage tennis right now. Working that backhand side of Michael Mull. Mull runs around the backhand to hit a forehand, but Ruben keeps going back there. He'll cover that drop shot easily. Ruben has Mo going corner to corner. Drop shot just didn't clear.
Love 30.
Even if it did, Michael Mo was going to get there.
Yeah.
Goes behind him, well executed by Noah Ruben. He really looks like he knows what he's doing and he knows how to finish this set. Michael Mo needs something good to happen for him to change this around a little bit.
15-30.
Noah Ruben, a very patient player. He doesn't really rush through things. He likes to take his time and think. Some players, you know, they want to push through these points. But Ruben, I like it. He thinks about what the situation is and what he wants to do. That looked wide. Mo on defense again. Nets. Very frustrated Ruben. He was on offense that entire point.
Yeah.
Just good defense by Michael Mo.
And a little trouble here for Noah Ruben, the 3 seed. Down a couple of break points. Altamirano up a set and up 2-1 in the second on court number 3, and a trainer's been called to attend to Stefan Kozlov. And it's 30-40 here on court number 2. Michael Mo fighting from behind in this final set down 1-3.
He has an opportunity to break and really can't afford to let this slip away. I mean, this is really maybe the match right here, the ability to get this service break on Noah Ruben. Ruben with a safe kick serve to the backhand, goes to the opening. Defense, Moe's gonna get there. He makes the volley. Back to deuce. If Moe fails to close the service break, that sequence may be the story of this entire match. Thank you.
Game point here for Noah Rubin.
Rubin gets back to deuce and works the backhand side of Mo and gets it done. And just smart tennis from Noah Rubin. Got away from Rubin. Back to deuce.
Mo not giving up on this one yet.
Yeah, frustrated Noah Rubin. Again, Rubin pounding the backhand. Oh, he runs around it with Michael Mo, but when he runs around that backhand, he opens up the other corner, and there is Rubin attacking it. And he attacks the opening. Yeah, just smart. Altamirano up 3-1 in their second set, with Altamirano taking the first set 6-4 over Stefan Kozlov. We haven't heard much of Kozlov's father from the stands at this point. Michael Mo in some trouble. I think there's back issues going on, is what it appears to me.
Yeah, he's been stretched out the last couple of points, and he's got his hands on his shorts the last after those points have concluded.
Oh, Mo just trying to end the point there. He just tried to end it 4-1. There's something that Michael Mo must feel he can't hang in long points, because that was a ball that he normally would have taken firm back up the middle.
Right.
He tried to hit a clean winner.
Michael Mo and Noah Rubin in a third and final set here from court number 2, the half of our 18 semifinals. Coverage here from Stowe Stadium on the campus of Kalamazoo College. In the other semifinal, Colin Altamirano trying to get back to his second consecutive final, the defending champion up a set and up 3-1 in the second over Stefan Kozlov.
Yeah, Altamirano has been rock steady this entire tournament. Looks like we could have a matchup of Altamirano-Rubin. Two steady baseline players.
And three out of the four players in the singles will see each other in the
doubles
final
as well, yeah.
Later. And Stefan Kozlov, Noah Rubin, partners, of course, against Dieten Baumann and Colin Altamirano. And Altamirano now up 4-1 second set. Stefan Kozlov received some medical treatment before the start of the second set. And here it's Michael Mo serving down 1-4 final set.
And Michael Mo desperate to let his service game get him back into this, but it looks like maybe the gas is drained out of the tank of Michael Mo. I think he had an opportunity earlier in the set to establish himself at the net, particularly with Rubin on that side of the court hitting into the wind. Long, but love 30. It looks like Noah Rubin feels this. He's ready. He's ready to go. Yep. Love
Love 40.
Yep, I have a feeling Michael Moe is checking out. Some physical issue combined with the steady play of Noah Rubin. Noah Rubin just going to put the ball back in play.
And if a physical injury weren't enough to overcome here in a semifinal match for Michael Moe, you've got to overcome a tough mental opponent in mm-hmm. Noah Rubin, and that's a really tall task.
Yeah, I mean, you can just tell by the body language, Michael Moe is, he doesn't really believe at this point. But he's going to keep hammering that first serve, and then he goes cute. I think Rubin knows it. Rubin safely inside the lines, not doing anything cute here. Ooh, he gets the error, finally.
30-40.
Michael Moe scratching and clawing. Can he find a burst of energy here? That big first serve would be welcome right now. And that's what he was looking for. Is he going to go big with the second one, or is he just going to kick it in? An error made earlier in the match. Mm-hmm. Yep, and there it is. Game Rubin.
And now Noah Rubin with the chance to serve out for the match, just dominating this
third set. Kozlov getting another visit from a trainer at 1-4 in the second set, and it doesn't look good for Stefan Kozlov. Left hip, it looks like, for Stefan Kozlov. Again, Rubin. He'll get there. Oh, great pass by Moe. If nothing else, Michael Moe has put on display his athletic ability.
Absolutely. And that being hindered a little bit here in this later stages of the third set with an apparent back injury, but Noah Rubin letting him hang around a little bit on this service game.
Yeah, Noah Rubin trying to serve for the match. We talk about it. It's one of the hardest things to do in tennis. That and hit a high backhand volley.
Even for a razor-sharp, mentally focused third seed.
And there's that forehand. We saw that earlier in the match. Noah swings him wide. Moe goes for everything with a clean winner. Noah Rubin making errors here. Visible frustration from Noah Rubin. 5-2.
The service break, and now 5-2, the third set lead for Noah Rubin. A visibly frustrated Noah Rubin, knowing that he could have just closed it out there, and now he's got to keep playing.
Yeah, all he really had to do was throw moon balls to the middle of the court. And I just don't know how much is left in the tank of Michael Moe. But now Michael Moe gets to serve again. And Michael Moe's, if he reels off 3 and 4 big first serves, it's 5-3 in a heartbeat, if he can do it.
and a variation of the between game routine of Noah Rubin there, dropping his racket from about 5 feet up instead of laying it down, but nonetheless... Well,
he laid the towel out, yeah, and he laid the racket next to the towel, as he normally does.
But Noah Rubin, visibly frustrated after that chance to close this match out, got away from him. But on the other side, Michael Moe, it's still yet to be seen how this medical, how the back strain, apparent back strain, is affecting him. Noah, rightfully so, is trying to spread him out, trying to test that back strain. And so far, Michael Moe passing those tests.
Well, I mean, what Rubin is thinking about is what I just mentioned is Michael Moe's serve is big enough to reel off several straight bombs and get him a service hold. And then you're looking at 5-3 and Noah Rubin trying to, for the second time, to serve out the match.
Now, Rubin knows that. Yeah. Michael Moe will serve now to stay in the match.
And 15 love.
Short points going the way of Michael Moe. 15 love.
That's what Michael Moe wants. He doesn't want a 20 ball rally here.
What a rip forehand from Noah Rubin, 15 all.
Tremendously entertaining singles and boys 18 semifinals, all four players. See, this is what Rubin was afraid of. Moe getting that big serve in, making one or two shots.
30-15.
Moe's probably going big here. Yep, he tried. Let another first serve coming. Oh, nice. Michael Moe kicking that first serve out to the backhand, opens up the court, takes the next short ball to the opening. Something that I think he could have done really this entire match. That first serve, there it is. 5-3 in a heartbeat.
Service hold, and Michael Moe hanging tough here on court number two. Has not thrown the towel in just yet, despite suffering an apparent back strain, showing off some good moves on that point.
Well, he relied on his big serve, and he got it done. Now Noah Rubin faced 5-3, still trying to serve out this third set and advancing. I mean, how much pressure is Noah Rubin feeling right now? He hasn't made it to a final here. That's what's going through his head. He's that close. He can see it. He can smell it. But he has not made it to a final in Kalamazoo. And he's one game away. Love 15. Yeah, the key might just be working. Michael Moe's backhand. And that's what he's trying.
Wind picking up at Stowe Stadium.
Blowing out of the north. He gets the air on the backhand side. I mean, that seems to be the formula for Noah Rubin here.
15 all.
He's not here right now, but if we asked tournament director Mark Riley about his feelings about today's crowd, he would be very pleased. Kudos to the Kalamazoo tennis community for turning out. Moe still able to crack that forehand.
15-30.
We get there. Yep. Oh my goodness! Let that thing finally close.
What an exchange! Michael Moe pumping the crowd up. 15:40, and we are 1 point away from being back on serve here.
Uh huh. This is what Noah Rubin was afraid of. It's 5-2 Altamirano in the second set on the other match. Right now, huge second serve at 15:40 for Noah Rubin.
Two break points and a second serve.
Ooh, barely.
Very close to being in.
Tough decision there for Rubin. What, do I hit it or do I let it go? And then the wind had died down a little bit. If the wind had been blowing like it had moments ago, that ball might have dropped on the line.
One break point fought off, one to go. 30-40.
A more aggressive Rubin coming out now. Still working that backhand side. Now he goes to the opening and gets the error.
Fights the break points off to deuce, and here we go. Buckle up. Noah Rubin fell behind quickly and was down 15-40. Peppering the backhand of Michael Moe. Fights off those break points now to deuce.
Ooh, oh, Rubin wanted the call. Kept playing, but he looked at the line judge. Oh, he's upset.
Break point?
Yeah, Noah Rubin now really upset. He thought that ball was long. He hit it back, but then looked daggers at that line judge. What a turn of events in this third set. Again. Oh, he was there.
Break point. Michael Moe holds on now. 4-5. And more importantly, we're on serve. But can Michael Moe hold here? This is a crucial hold for Michael Moe.
Well, now the momentum has shifted. Yeah. It's Michael Moe. Regardless of whatever issue he's having with his back, Noah Rubin had this thing locked up. It started to slip away. He got really upset at a line call at the baseline. During the point, stopped and looked at that line judge. Now Michael Moe serving to get even at 5-all. Amazing.
And we've brought it up the last couple of days, in particular with the quarterfinals and semifinals going on. They add the line judges to the court, and Colin Altamirano inching closer to his second consecutive finals bid on court three. But we've brought it up about, you know, you got to play the ball. It's almost like you got to put blinders on and just play until you hear something.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. And that's what the coaches, I'm sure, have already talked to both players about. And they would keep reminding them in the third set is you play every ball until it's called out by a lines person
because
or the chair umpire.
Quite honestly, it doesn't matter what you have to say about the line call. The call's up to, well, ultimately the chair umpire, but on the lines made by the line judges. And then,
but that was a big turning point. Yeah. And now can Michael Moe continue this dramatic comeback in the third set of the boys 18 singles semifinal? The winner getting to the final. Noah Rubin having found himself here in a semifinal yet again.
15 love. Yep.
Michael Moe relying on that big first serve. And we see Mark Riley strolling toward the crowd in his green jacket. Again, Michael Moe relying on that big serve. I sense third set tiebreaker. I just do.
And
three serves in a row from Michael Moe.
And no returns. from Noah Rubin.
Drop shot. Look at Rubin covers that.
And there you go.
I'm going to say it again. You cannot be cute against Noah Rubin because Rubin will cover it.
40-15.
Oh, called good.
Service ace.
Oh, my.
And on court three, Colin Altamirano, game, set, match. Straight sets over Stefan Kozlov, 6-4, 6-2. So the defending champion will be back to defend his title tomorrow here on center court at Stowe Stadium.
No longer an unseeded,
no,
relatively unknown player, Colin Altamirano. But who's he going to face, Carolyn? We've still got to decide that.
Noah Rubin will go to a second serve after dropping that last game quite easily on Michael Moe's serve, and he is feeling it. Michael Moe.
Mm-hmm.
Showing no worse for the wear on the back strain. Love 15.
Huge, huge pressure on Noah Rubin right here. Ooh, that was... Ruben's ball was long, but Rubin cannot believe.
Love 30.
He cannot believe that Moe's ball wasn't called long, and neither can I, frankly.
You know, I mean, we're above it.
This
baseline, so it's really hard for us to have the depth perception to make that call. We have a pretty good look at Moe's baseline down here.
Ultimate test of focus right here for Noah Rubin. That's going to go long.
That is long. 15-30. The defending champion signing some autographs for some really excited ball kids. And a great match over there. Straight sets over Stefan Kozlov in the 5 seed now. Will make his second straight appearance in the finals.
Put it underneath the mic cable. Oh, net court fell over for Rubin. Sails long. What a battle. Huge forehand from Michael Moe. Wide with the forehand from Rubin.
To deuce we go.
Man, can't get much closer than this. Big serve by Rubin, but the next ball 8 feet long.
And now match point facing.
No, it's actually break point.
Break point facing.
It's five all. Break point. It's five all is what I've got.
Yeah.
Service break. Ooh, big kick serve handcuffed Moe. He'll get there. Great defense by Rubin, and then Mo over hits the ball.
Back to Deuce.
Just great defense by Noah Rubin. Colin Altamirano making his way out up the stairs and over to the tower. What a match. What a semifinal.
Straight sets victory for Colin Altamirano.
We should point out the Altamirano-Kozlov match started a half hour after this one.
Yeah.
Did. Oh. Again, it's that backhand unforced error that has crept up and bit Michael Mo. Smart. Oh, I like the
back
choice
to
of serves.
Yeah.
From Noah Rubin kicking that ball out to the backhand. But he made backhand error into the net court himself. Tremendous pressure on every swing of the racket at this point. Ooh, generated an arrow.
Let was called.
Let? Did he call? Okay, I guess he did. Missed that one, but that was long as well.
Yeah.
It's just stunning that the service line judge over here didn't call that, and he gets a double fault. That's where Noah Rubin needed to slow himself down.
Yeah, instead of
prepare
going
for,
right back to the yeah, second serve.
Prepare for that second serve instead of rushing himself into it.
Break point now facing Noah Rubin.
And kicks it out. Good job.
Gets the air.
Kicks it out to the back end. Gets the air. Now he should try that here. Try that from deuce court. Just that kick serve to the backhand side of Michael Mo. Don't hang a ball to Michael Mo's forehand. You know, you can almost see that Ruben's coach trying to tell him that telepathically. And he does it. Oh, almost got the error. Wide with that forehand. Tremendous point. Advantage, Rubin. Now, quiz, Carolyn. Where do you think Noah Rubin is going to put this first serve?
Got to go to the backhand.
You think so?
That's think what's
he's gonna,
working.
You think he's going to kick it to the backhand of Michael Mo?
That's what's been working for him, so.
If he's got any sense, that's where he's going with his first serve.
Logic tells me. Time to kick it to the backhand.
And he does. Again, working that backhand side. Oh. Rubin got there, couldn't get it up.
Back to deuce.
Almost the error from
yeah,
Mo
I mean,
there.
It, that painted the sideline on Michael Moe's backhand. Well, that's the safer side to go if you're Rubin to try and generate an error. Those shots have been there for Michael Mo when he's needed them on the backhand side.
Well, again, choice of where you go with your first serve.
I mean, it's got to go backhand the entire time.
I mean, it is the smarter play. And he tried to go wide to the forehand. Now, he's been burned wide where Mo has crushed balls. Don't know why you'd go back there. But he gets an error there. Lucky break. Advantage Rubin.
Hold point, game point, Noah Rubin.
And again, the breeze has picked up significantly this moment from the north, blowing into, oh, a broken string? I think so. Mo taking his time, walking over to replace his racket, strolling very slowly, letting Noah Rubin stew.
He's got long legs. He can walk faster than that.
He's telling the cheer umpire, that was my favorite racket in the world, and now I broke a string.
This is a psychological thing here.
Mo taking his time like that. Here we go. Advantage Rubin. Got that forehand to sit.
Hold for Noah Rubin, 6-5, and now on the other side of the court, a must-hold situation for the 7-seed Michael Mo.
And we hope that Bob Wood is getting his vocal cords limbered up. Director, if you would, kind of tap Bob Wood on his shoulder and say, please get that wonderful voice of his ready to join us for the doubles.
And Bob Wood, a story tradition of joining the broadcast for the final rounds.
So, director,
doubles. Please
have Mr. Shaw up there in the booth give Bob Wood a tap on the shoulder. Say, please get those wonderful vocal tones ready to join us for the doubles.
We'll look forward to having Bob Wood with us. In the meantime, I think you're right, Hap. We're smelling a third set match tiebreaker.
Mm-hmm.
But it all is going to depend on the service game of Michael Mo. We've seen it shaky at times here throughout the match. And,
Director, you got it. No, you got it right. Mr. Director, have Mr. Shaw, have Bob Wood get his voice ready to join us.
While Bob Wood warms up his vocal cords, we'll await the service game here of Michael Mo. And just going for everything on that.
Well, he has to. He's relied on. Oh, broken string, I think, from Rubin. He's trying to get it over his head. That's going to go long. Way to go, Rubin, with a broken string.
What does that do to the tennis ball?
Well, you don't get the same feel off the racket because you've lost 10 pounds of tension just from the break alone.
Of one string.
Okay. And boy, that you heard the break.
Yeah.
And he kept playing, and he ended up winning the point. Fabulous job of concentration. And he lost his vibration dampener. Just a great job by Noah Rubin there.
Well, before we have Bob Wood join us, looks like we're going to have Mark Riley once again looking sharp in the green jacket. Enjoying this semifinal match between Noah Rubin and Michael Mo. And love 30 for Michael Mo. In a little bit of a hole here, coach, as he tries to move on to the final.
What a match.
Yeah. Tournament director, coach Mark Riley.
I have to ask you, how happy are you with the crowd in the stands today?
Well, I wanted to say that first of all, but I don't want to be too self-serving, but the crowd is unbelievable.
Not as unbelievable as that shot. Wow, well, Michael Mo.
This is an amazing match, and Rubin was so tough to win that 5-all game, but the Michael Mo, I believe, was down love 30 there, and he just made the shot of the match.
I've been hoping to see Michael Mo get to the net more, use that athleticism, but he's been content to stay on the baseline and bash with Noah Rubin.
I think maybe as his game develops, he's going to spend more time up there because he's big and bad, got a huge serve, and he can put his physical nature on the other guy. I think his opponent would worry more.
30 all.
Well, I just noticed there was a point in this third set where Mo looked like he got a little passive. but he fought his way back. We know he's having some kind of health issue, medical issue, because of the trainer was out there.
You know, that's what happens. Guys develop, they learn that they have to hit you the ball. I mean, no reason when that fly ball came because he hit you a few times. Big, big moment.
Oh, Justin wasn't able to roll that thing back into the court.
40-30 now.
I told Carolyn earlier in this third set, I smelled a third set tiebreaker.
Yeah, a lot of people out here hoping for that because as tennis fans, we love to see people suffering.
Again, huge. Ruben, defensive return. Gets it to drop on the line. I pointed out just a moment ago, Ruben's ability to win a point after he broke a string on the service return. He kept chipping, and ended up winning the point. A lot of players would have given up on the point. Oh, Ruben's going to cover it. Oh, he pushed it wide.
Ruben grow up before our eyes. You know, 4 years here, and he's just each year gotten a little better. But this year, I see a different maturity level here, and I think it's paying off for him right now.
Yeah, in this tight situation, we've talked about that, the mental maturity of Noah Ruben, and now a chance here to advance.
I mentioned it before. Michael Mull, this is his first experience in Kalamazoo. This is going to be a huge learning curve for him. Okay, yeah, it's not going to get it done.
Back to deuce.
No matter what happens with him the rest of the way, he's going to look back at this experience and feel like he's really made it happen for himself. And he's going to be considering himself as one of his top guys now.
Again, display of huge forehands by both players. Ruben moving forward, getting behind him. He had a choice of either going back behind Mo or pushing it to his left. Executed by Noah Ruben.
Michael Mo suffered a back strain earlier in the match and limping around the court now.
Coach says it looks like a cramp. Right calf cramp, yeah.
Able to come strong with that forehand in a crucial situation.
Mm-hmm.
Semifinals, trying to get to his first final here at Kalamazoo in singles. He's going to be teeing himself up to play in the doubles this afternoon, but boy, bucket to be able to come through that with the pressure.
Okay, the question is, can Michael Moe call for another medical timeout here?
So.
That means he's got to play through it.
Yeah,
it's what he's got to do. He's got really no choice. He can take a little time to try and walk it out, but
the double fault, game, set, and match to Noah Ruben. And
Thank you, Coach.
His third shot at getting to the finals. He does so. Our thanks to Mark Riley for joining us for that dramatic ending, the three-set battle between two very worthy opponents. Noah Ruben, the three seed, moving on. 6-7, 6-2, and 7-5. And with that, we welcome Bob Wood into the tower. Your thoughts
we
on that
get
last
his,
semifinal match.
We got to get his
match.
Thoughts on this because Bob has seen all of this before.
But it was a very, very hard-fought match, and that's what everybody...